Hello everybody and welcome back to my channel. Just woke up to about 10 messages regarding the news on the DreamWorks Netflix Jurassic World spin-off show Camp Cretaceous. It looks like a mini trailer has dropped today showing a beautiful junglescape along with some soothing jungle sounds. When all of a sudden we come face to face with a stunning animated raptor. The raptor is so realistic looking and I was quite surprised when I first saw it. I was half expecting some sort of Lego creature or something budget looking, but if they maintain that quality throughout the show, I'm actually quite impressed. And they also provided this picture. Look at those gates there. Definitely has that Jurassic ominous feel. I really, really like the design of this. It looks so true to the original franchise. So the raptor in the trailer did lash out at us. And in the Jurassic franchise, it's known for a little bit of family-friendly carnage. Not necessarily kind of Netflix, DreamWorks, Pictures, carnage friendly. So I think they're really gonna have to dial down on that. So I wonder how they're gonna balance that aspect out of the franchise. Are people gonna die in this series? Will people get eaten? Will there be blood? You know, who's it rated for? So along with the trailer, they also provided a mini press release here. So I thought we could skim through that quickly and maybe get some of those details to our burning questions and our burning loins, and we can maybe answer some of those. DreamWorks Animation today announced Jurassic World Camp Cretaceous, an animated action-adventure series, is set to debut globally on Netflix in 2020. What is it today? Today's like June 2019. Ah, still so long! As part of an ongoing multi-year agreement with Netflix to produce original animated kids and family programming. Okay, so it looks like this is kid-friendly, so I guess we will be getting a lot of those, you know, kind of chase scenes, a lot of suspense and hiding behind things like, phew, that was close, but no one getting eaten? Maybe? I don't know. That's just one thing I really, really did like about the Jurassic franchise, is that slight gore factor to kind of keep things interesting. You know, to not have that in here would be very odd to me. But then again, they may actually have all that, you know, kind of quote unquote gore, but in a roundabout kid-friendly way. Let's get back here. Set within the same timeline as the 2015 blockbuster film Jurassic World, the Netflix original series is inspired by the multi-billion dollar franchise from Universal Pictures and Amblin Entertainment. Jurassic World Camp Cretaceous follows a group of six teenagers chosen for a once-in-a-lifetime experience at a new adventure camp on the opposite side of Isla Nublar. I want to go to Camp Cretaceous! But when dinosaurs wreak havoc across the island, the campers are stranded, unable to reach the outside world. They'll need to go from strangers to friends to family if they're going to survive. Okay, so from the picture that they released, it looks like these are our six teenagers right here. This is the I can't live without my cell phone pink snooty girl. This is the adventure girl. I'm sure we got a mean jock guy, a smart tech guy, a peaceful leader guy in there too as well. So it sounds like they are on the island when the Indominus Rex causes all the chaos in Jurassic World, ultimately leading to dinosaurs running all over the place, its abandonment, and closure. Seems like they kind of missed their ride off the island there and have to band together to survive through the turmoil. No doubt coming into contact with all sorts of dinosaurs like the T-Rex, Raptors, Indominus Rex, Mosasaurus, etc. What I'm really looking forward to is perhaps seeing some older abandoned areas from the first Jurassic Park that we maybe didn't get to see in the first Jurassic World. Maybe they'll even find Alan's raptor claw. Maybe we'll find that Barbasol can. Perhaps they can add to the canon and story of the Jurassic franchise by answering some questions that we have always had, like what happened to this, how did this happen, or maybe even the kids' involvement were able to aid in some of the events in Jurassic World. So like maybe the kids at Camp Cretaceous saw Rexy fighting the Indominus Rex at the end of Jurassic World, and they were the ones who opened the Mosasaur pen and were the reason for killing the Indominus Rex. Like that would actually be really cool, a tie-in, you know, if they would show things like that in the show. See, that's something that I would actually be really excited about. Scott Kramer or Kramer or something, Pinky Malinky, and Lane Rara, Kung Fu Panda, The Paws of Destiny, serve as showrunners and executive producers. The series is executive produced by Steven Spielberg, Frank Marshall, and Colin Trevorrow. Zach Stentz serves as consulting producer. Jurassic World Camp Cretaceous builds on a successful 5-year relationship between DreamWorks Animation and Netflix that has seen 18 years from Universal Pictures and Amblin Entertainment. The Jurassic World franchise immerses audiences of all ages in a new era of wonder and thrills where dinosaurs and humankind must learn to coexist. Yeah, Jurassic World is more than a film franchise. At every turn, this $5 million film series delivers a larger-than-life destination for exploration, discovery, and epic adventure. Dinosaurs live again, and they live in Jurassic World. The third installment in the Jurassic World film series hits theaters on July 11th, 2021. Oh, so far away! Where dinosaurs and humankind must learn to coexist, eh? I guess they are maybe talking about the third film installment because we were left with dinosaurs essentially, you know, kind of running loose there in the second film. So I guess they're talking about the third installment, I suppose. So in the comments down below, everyone, I'd love to hear your thoughts on Camp Cretaceous. At first I was like, this is kind of weird. But the more I think about it, I really do love the idea of this spin-off show. But at the same time, I wish that it was a little more tailored to a little older audience, but I understand why they want to make it accessible for as many kids as possible. And I do appreciate that. I think that it should be accessible to all ages, but at the same time, I'm greedy and I want some gore and I want it to be a little bit more darker. My only hope is that it's not going to be too kiddish, where the dinosaurs don't even seem like a threat anymore, and the kids are now making like coconut necklaces and banana phones for Valentine's Day, and that's like an episode. But at the same time, that aggressive raptor in the trailer kind of sets my mind at ease, because he did show like a lot of aggression, and not only was his animation beautiful, but just that aggression just made me think, okay, everything's gonna be okay. So I'd love to hear your thoughts in the comments down below. So please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. I come out with new videos every week. Come check me out on social media and help support the channel on Patreon. So thank you guys so much for watching, and stay legendary.